on quarantine day. I lost count about 30 days ago. So what I'm doing right now is just getting my lemons going. I don't know why my voice always changes when I do these videos, but it's just what happens. I got this troublemaker over here. No, you know. Okay, so we're just gonna get these chicken breasts. Go ahead and get that done right there. Like,
you squirted me.
Okay, I'm sorry.
And the camera.
It's mine. So get a lot of it in there. As long as the seeds fall in there, that's no big deal. I just like a lot of lemon because we're making lemon chicken. And what's cool about making lemon chicken rice and beans is that you got three ingredients for tomorrow to make enchiladas.
Yay!
So you went ahead and saw me season that or lemon it up. There's no trick here. You just rub it in there. I mean, not literally rub it in there, but just make sure every little nook and cranny is covered. What I do is I kind of do an alternating seasonal. Again, Weber, garlic in there. Thank you, Marmy. I love you. Anyways, just kind of doing my do. And then again, and then see, oh no, it came all off. So I didn't want to overdo it at first. Look how nice. And then we're gonna go ahead and redo it, and then we'll pretty much just leave it as is, and we'll just throw it right back in the oven. I'm gonna go ahead and cook it like at 425, I think. If I change my mind, I will make an adjustment later in the video. And then as a little quick topper, put little lemon slices. 1, 2, 3. I like putting it on like the fat portion of the breast.
That's where you get all the good stuff.
Yeah. Got a little junior in the making. And actually, I just changed my mind again. We're going to go ahead and put these underneath.
Oh, that's better.
Yeah, because I want this to brown on top. And I realized that as I was putting down my peels, that some of the seasoning came off. So, again, got my nice little crust, and that'll just bake over it just like perfect.
Yeah!
If you have a meat thermometer, you want to put it at 165.
Okay!
So, what we did here was simply pour the beans, and now we're picking out all the bad ones. And we're gonna go ahead and do these beans in an Instapot. Why am I showing you how to make beans? Because everybody went out and bought beans and rice. Y'all got home and realized, ah, crud, I can't stick this in the microwave. So I'm gonna show you how to make an awesome recipe of beans and rice. Anyways, so we filled it up with a couple of cups of water, and now we're gonna dice up, yeah, you can see our cleaning supplies, dice some onion and garlic and just throw it all in there. You can see the garlic we already pre-smashed, nothing fancy here. So before we put the onion and garlic in, what we're doing is we're turning on the Instapot, and we're basically kind of doing like a wannabe saute, but we're anyways, I only do one take, all right? Basically to boil and burn off the starch and stuff like that. So we're doing like a pre-boil, and then we'll throw in the ingredients, and then we'll set it for what, 30 minutes? 30 minutes, and Instead of waiting 5 hours, you get beans in 30 minutes. Quick little rice setup. It's a pan. You're gonna add oil to it. You got rice. You got nor, but it's called caldo de pollo. That's how you have to ask for it when you go to a Mexi market. A little bit of butter if you don't want to use oil. And then a bag of frozen vegetables, like mixed vegetables. See this big ass container of rice? We're only going to use 1 cup. That's it. How many? Two cups of rice?
Yeah, because I'm making a big batch so we can freeze some of it.
Did you hear that? We're freezing some of it. So that means it's going to be 2 cups of water, or 2 cups of rice and about four cups of water. You'd think I should know these recipes, but I did teach her. And then she got better when she met my mom. Yeah, we always put onion on everything. So all we're doing right now is about to wash some rice. It's going to be exciting. I promise. See? We're washing the rice. It's very exciting. Sip, 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 sip. We're washing.
And why we wash it, I have no idea, but it makes the rice turn out so much better.
Yep. Pay attention. Sip, 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 sip. All right, I'm bored. So, we put the butter in the pan, and then we put the olive oil, because olive oil is our best friend.
Olive oil, scientifically, raises the cooking temperature of the butter to prevent your rice from burning.
That too, but I was thinking, if you're trying to sweet talk a lady, and you bust out your Barry White voice, it might Batman. Work.
Batman.
Oh my gosh. We're stirring the beans. Just before the ingredients go in.
Well, we have to keep it boiling for a little bit longer until it boils some of the starch out.
See? She's such a better narrator than I am. Get that sizzle going. Right now we got the temp on high. Basically just kind of not burn your rice, but cook it. So you're going to have to stir it frequently. Throw in a little bit of onion because I like onion. My dad likes onion.
I like onion.
My beautiful wife Shannon likes onion. That was a little bit of garlic. Probably should go like that. Because I'm sitting sideways, the camera was going that way. And this is kind of boring, so just keep stirring until it turns a little brown. You'll smell it when it's ready, and if it smells burnt, then you've cooked it for too long. So all I did was put my beautiful chicken in the oven at 425. Over here, we're still stirring. So at this point, after the pre-sizzle boil, we went ahead and added half a garlic, and it looks like three teeth of garlic. And then we're using a whole handful of loveliness called salt. And that one comes from Mexico, because my dad brought. So it's like big old like rock salt.
So the Instapot is a pressure cooker. So typically beans take freaking forever to cook.
Yeah.
In the Instapot, they take about 50 minutes. So I try to fill it maybe 2 or 3 inches above the bean line. So we did boil them to get some of the starches out. Probably could add a little more water. Yeah, I'll do that. Just up to the max fill line. So in our Instapot, we have to put the lid on.
Yeah, that's super tricky.
But this thing is a lifesaver. It cooks everything super fast. We're going to put it on. We're going to cancel it. We were sautéing in it. Or not. So we're going to go up to pressure cook. Push it. It goes over. I'm going to set the timer for 50 minutes. Maybe a little less. I do a natural pressure release, so when you do the natural pressure release, and we're going to go high pressure, when you do the natural pressure release, it actually cooks some more. So, because we sautéed the beans and they're already warm, it comes up to temperature a lot faster. But it'll take like a few minutes to come up to pressure, and then the 45 minutes, and then you have bean soup.
Ta-da! Remember, subscribe on the... Wait, what is it?
On the grill fresh.
Yeah, on the grill with fresh. Alrighty. So, this is what it's supposed to look like. See, it's a little brownage, not burntage. Add in your mixed veggies. We're using half a bag. Something I didn't mention was the Del Monte sauce. Give it a quick stir. And you have to do it in this order. That's what my mom says. See it? It goes into the rice. I just like looking at this because it looks like slop right now. It's one of those things where you're just gonna go, just add water. Bam! So it's kind of like making pasta. So if you want to think of it that way, you can do rice even easier without doing all these little knickknacks, paddywhacks. Give a dog a bone. See the water go in. Yeah. Oh yeah. And the water keeps going. So from here, I'm just gonna bring the water to a boil, cover up for about, what, 20, 25 minutes, and call it a day. I'm not gonna show you this step. That's how it comes out. We got the baby doing the salmonella process. What are you doing? What are you doing? Oh my god. I can't control you, huh? Tortillas. I would do it old school, but I'm lacking oven space, so we're good. Oh, you want to see the chicken? La la! Perfect. so I'm ready to eat.